Welcome to a third example of describing and then graphing a trig transformation. Here we have y equals 2 sine of the quantity 1 half pi x minus 1. So looking at our notes for the transformations of the sine function, we need to recognize here that a is equal to 2, which will affect the amplitude. B is equal to 1 half pi, or pi over 2, which will affect the period. And C is equal to negative 1, which will be a vertical shift up or down. So let's go through each of these. The absolute value of A is the amplitude. So the absolute value of 2 is 2. So our amplitude is 2. 2 pi divided by B will tell us the period. So 2 pi divided by 1 half pi, or pi over 2, well, that's the same as 2 pi times 2 over pi. So notice how in this case the pi's simplify out and our period is equal to 4 units. There's no pi in our period this time, which may seem strange but actually makes it easier to graph. And then lastly, C would be negative 1, which means the graph will be shifted down 1 unit. So now we have everything. We have the amplitude, period, and the vertical shift. Let's start by talking about the vertical shift. If this graph is shifted down 1 unit, the midline is no longer going to be y equals 0, it's going to be y equals negative 1. So if this is negative 1 on the y-axis, this will be our new midline. Next, our amplitude is positive 2, which means from the midline, we'll go up 2 units and down 2 units to mark where the max and mins will occur. So if we go up 2 from negative 1, we'll be at positive 1. And if we go down 2 from negative 1, we'd be at negative 3. Our period is 4 units, so we'll graph this function from 0 to 4, and we'll divide this interval into 4 equal parts. So we have 2, 1, and 3. And now we're ready to graph this based upon what we know about the parent sine function, where it starts at the midline, at the next fourth it's at a maximum, the next fourth is at the midline, then a minimum, and then back to the midline. So for our graph, we'll start at the midline, which is at negative 1 on the y-axis. The next fourth will be up at a maximum, which will be up 2 units to positive 1. The next fourth will be back to the midline. At the next fourth, we'll be at a minimum of negative 3, and then we'll finish back at the midline. And now we have the 5 key points to make a nice graph of the given function. It would look something like this. And again, if you need to review how A, B, C, and D affect the graph of the sine function, I'll leave you with those notes.